Hello, so today we will discuss what are the different types of condenser. So last class we have discussed what is condenser and what is the condensing plant and function of condenser. Okay, so today we will discuss that types of condenser. So they broadly, if we classify it broadly, then we will get two types of condenser. So we can say that the condenser may be broadly classified as one is called surface condenser. Surface condenser, or this is also known as non-mixing. Non-mixing type condenser. Okay, and second one we have direct contact type. Direct contact type, or this is our jet condenser. Okay, so this broadly we can classify condenser as two types. One is surface condenser, another one is jet condenser. Surface condenser also known as non-mixing type, and jet condenser also known as direct contact type. So non-mixing means there is no mixing of water or circulating water and steam. And mixing or jet means here circulating water and our steam will mixed directly. Okay, so first let's discuss. First one is our surface condenser. Okay, so let's see the surface condenser. So if we see the surface condenser, we'll get this is on schematic diagram of a surface condenser. So basically surface condenser is a cell and tube types heat exchanger, okay, where the two fluids do not come in direct contact and the heat is transferred to the cooling water continuously. Okay, so basically a surface condenser is a cell and tube type heat exchanger where the two fluid means steam and the circulating water does not or do not come in direct contact and the heat is transferred to the cooling water continuously. Okay, so this is our surface condenser. So we can say it is cell and tube heat exchanger where the two fluid means steam is one fluid and circulating water. Okay, steam and circulating two fluid do not come in direct contact and the heat is transferred to the cooling water continuously. Okay, so this is our surface condenser. So let's see the construction. So coming to the construction, our surface condenser consists a cell and tube. Means here if you see that outer, this is known as cell. That outer cover is known as cell. And inside there is a number of tubes. These are the tubes. okay? So there is a number of tubes, okay? So that's why this is known as cell and tube, means inside a cell number of tubes is inserted, okay? And there is in the both sides, here if you see this side, we have divided water box. This is called divided water box, okay? This is one box and it is divided by some partitions. This is used to do for not mixing, or so that our water, which water entering and the water which leaving, both two are not mixing or do not mix. And here we have undivided water box, okay? After that, at the bottom, already we have seen a condensing plant, that is hot oil. Here that condensate is stored, or after that steam is condensed, that condensed liquid is stored at hot oil, and from that hot oil it is going to our boiler, already we have seen. And here we have seen that is that steam is coming from the turbine here, and so this is, and here another this is the number of plates, okay? So this is perforated plates through which our tubes has inserted, because of giving the support of the tubes, because that length of the tube is too large, okay? So too large tube, so that's why it is inserted to a perforated plates for giving the support of the tubes. Otherwise the tubes may get bent, okay? So tubes may get bent, that's why we have given support by the use of plate, okay? So basically that that cell is made of steel cast iron, okay? And always that tubes is in the horizontal, it is kept horizontally. Now let's see the working. So water is entering through the bottom water box, and from that water is entering, and from the top steam is coming, or that steam is exhausted to that cell. So through the tube water is flowing. Why? Because of easy cleaning and maintenance, the water is flowing through the tube, and the steam enters at the top and is forced to flow downwards over the tubes due to suction of extraction pump. So here we put some extraction pump, and from the top that steam is forced to flow downwards, and this is coming due to the extraction pump or condensate extraction pump. There is a pressure difference, so that's why that steam is forced to flow over the tube, and through the tube our cooling water is flowing, okay? So that from this cooling water is entering, this is flowing through, and this is going back. So basically this is a two pass heat exchanger, means double flow, through that our water is flowing through two pipes and leaving through two pipes, okay? So after that the circulating water is leaving through the upper. So keep it in mind, upper box. So keep it in mind, the cooling water always flow through the lower half of the tubes into the condenser and returns through the upper half of the tubes, okay? So this is our surface condenser. So basically where do we use that surface condenser, okay? So what is the application? So here if you see that there is a no direct mixing of steam and circulating water, that's why that purity of condensate is maintained, Okay, means what are the condensate we get? This condensate is pure, and we can use or circulate this condensate directly without treatment. Okay, so that's why we use this condenser where we have limited quantity of good quality water. Where we will get a limited quantity of good quality water, there we will be using surface condenser, because we can reuse the condensate again and again. Okay, so this is, so basically it has been seen in many ships where there is a limitation to carry a good quality of water. That's why generally it is used in ships. Okay, and the in many land installation where we can't use that fresh water, because the quality of fresh water is not good. So that's why generally the places where our good quality water is less, there we use this kind of condenser. Okay, so we can say that it is essential in ships which can carry only a limited, which can carry only limited quantity of fresh water for the boiler. Okay, also it can be used for land, also it can be used, or it can be used in land installation where less quantity and less quantity good quality water is available. Okay, so this is in this place, but we can use it anywhere, but where we have such kind of limitation or available unavailability of good quality water, in that places we use this surface condenser. Let's discuss about the second type of condenser, that is a direct contact type or jet type condenser. Okay, so in jet type, basically what happens that in jet type, condensate and cooling water directly mix and come out as a single steps. Okay, so jet condenser is a direct contact type condenser. We can say that in jet condenser, condensate and cooling water directly mix, cooling water directly mix and come out as single stream. Okay, so this is our jet condenser. Earlier in surface condenser, that cooling water and condensate is not mixed directly, but here what happened that there is a mixing of cooling water and the exhaust stream, and after mixing they will come as a single stream as a saturated liquid. Okay, so let's see that what happens. If we see, so we have this as a jet condenser. Okay, so here if we see, this is our jet condenser. Okay, so what happens that here we have in the condenser cell, this one is condenser cell. Okay, and here we have used perforated conical plates. Perforated means there is a holes. Okay, there is a holes, and through that holes that water is spraying on the below sides. Okay, from that water is spread on this. Okay, so after that we have trays. This tray also in the form of perforated, or there is a perforation on the tray. So what happens first, water is falling from that conical plate, after that it's falling onto this tray, and from that tray also this is falling to another one, that is we have another one tray. Okay, so there is a number of tray or perforated plates through which water is falling. Okay, and after that we have, this is a condensate pump. The condensate is stored here, and through the that condensate is extracted from this to the hot oil, and if there is increase in quantity of hot oil, then it's overflow to the another one tank, that is known as cooling water. Okay, so already I mentioned that in jet condenser, what happens in jet condenser, our cooling water and exhaust steam both are directly mixing, and after mixing we'll get one liquid as in the form of condensate. So as a result, that quantity of condensate is increases. Okay, so now let's see that how it works. So at the top portion there is a air pump. Through that air pump it is created a suction. So due to that suction, that cooling water from the cooling water tank is going upwards, and from there it is spread through the number of perforated conical plates, and the exhaust steam is coming from the bottom. Exhaust steam is coming from the bottom. Okay, so this steam is going up through that perforated seats or perforated trays, and from the top that water is coming, and they are mixing together one by one because there is a perforation or perforated tray, so they are getting obstructed, and there is more contact between steam and saturated between steam and cooling water. Due to that there is a condensation of the exhaust steam, and this steam or condensate is stored at the bottom of the condenser cell. So now you can understand why we have used that conical or perforated conical plates, number of trays or conical plates, so that there is more contacts between exhaust steam and the cooling water. Okay, so here if you see that our steam is going upwards, our steam is going upwards and cooling water is coming downwards. Okay, so the flow is in two different direction. So that's why these types of condenser is known as counter flow condenser also. This type of condenser is also known as counter flow condenser. In some types of condenser, what happens that steam as well as cooling water is flowing in the same direction. So that condenser is known as our parallel flow condenser. Okay, so here if you see that our cooling water as well as our steam is mixing, and we are getting together as a condensate. So we can say that this condensate is not pure as that we have seen in surface condenser. Okay, so we can say that this is a less pure, or the purity is not there. If due to that we don't use this condensate huge quantity for the next cycle, because for this condensate we need to treat again, or there is required for treatment, water treatment or feed water treatment. So that's why there is a loss of condensation. Due to that, the cost also increases. Okay, so now let's see that what is the application. So application, we can say the application of that jet condenser. See the application. Just application. So where we can use, so earlier case in surface condenser we see that where there is a limitation of good quality of water, there we can use the surface condenser. But for jet condenser, if there is a limitation, we can't use this surface jet condenser, because this is not pure as that in surface condenser. And if we use this water as a circulation, then our the different component of boiler, turbine, and there will be a reduction in lifetime, because in this kind of condensate there is a different minerals which make or which corrode the component of turbine boiler. So due to that we can't use this one. So basically this is used where good quality of water is available in large quantity or huge quantity. Okay, so there we can use, but if there is a limitation of good quality of water, then we can't use. Okay, so this is our jet condenser. So construction and working. In jet condenser, again if we make the classification of jet condenser, then we can get three types of jet condenser. Okay, so three types of jet condenser is there. One, we have already I told, parallel flow. Two, we have counter flow. Okay, and third, we have ejector condenser. Okay, so parallel counter flow already I told. In ejector condenser, what happens that in ejector type of condenser, that exhaust steam and cooling water is mixed in a series of truncated cone. Means this ejector type, there will be mixing of cooling water and steam is in the form of truncated cone, like that. There is a truncated cone shape, and from this side cooling water will come, and from bottom there will be a steam. So these will be mixing in that. There is a no perforated tray or perforated plate. So there is a, due to truncated, there will be obstruction, and they will come in more and more contacts. Okay, so that's why this is our ejector condenser. Okay, so these three kinds jet condenser you can see. Many other types of condenser also is there, barometric condenser and spray condenser. So these are also is known as spray condenser, because cooling water is spraying on the exhaust steam. Okay, so we can say this spray condenser also. Spray means just cooling water will spray on the exhaust steam, and our exhaust steam will condense. Okay, so let's see the next topic, that is, what is the difference between jet condenser and surface condenser. Okay, so this is, let's see the difference between jet condenser and surface condenser. So in jet condenser, what happens, that first our cooling water and steam are mixed, is that heat transfer occurs by mixing of cooling water and steam. But in surface condenser, there is a no direct mixing of cooling water and steam. Okay, so next we can say that it is used for low capacity plant, because we need again and again that fresh water for circulation. That's why we can't or we don't use this for high power plant. Okay, so similarly it is suitable, you can say that it is used for high capacity plant. Okay, high capacity plant. Next, it requires less quantity of circulating water circulating water, and here we used large quantity circulating water. It is economical and simple. This plant is costly and complicated. Okay, so next here if we see that in jet condenser, already we have seen that condensate is not reused. Okay, so we can say that condensate is wasted. Okay, for that we have used the condensate. So we can say that condensate is reused. Okay, here our maintenance cost is low. And we have this side, maintenance cost is high. Okay, so these are the some difference between jet condenser and surface condenser. So first you write the use, all those things. Okay, so today up to this, next class we will see the another topics. So thank you for your kind attention.